Let's add dependency to mod menu, a very nice little mod that shows extra information about your mod list as a player and gives information about each mod that are really nice to have. Normally, you would like to have this dependency in every mod you develop. Hello, everyone. This is Ali Reza. Welcome to the Mentor Code Lab. If you look at modrint for mod menu, now, normally in Forge, we have a little button on the start menu that shows mods text. And when you click, you will see this window, lots of mods being listed. And if you click on each mod, you will see some infos. And if it has configs, there is a button for config and stuff like that. Fabric doesn't provide this functionality by default. That is why we have mod menu as a little mod that almost every player adds to the game. Now, if you go to the source, it's on GitHub, and they tell you how to add dependency for mod menu. But I will do it myself, and there is nothing wrong checking the GitHub. You can do it yourself. However, there is a second mod that depends on mod menu, and that is called mod menu badges. Now, by default, mod menu may show one of these few little boxes that says client or library or deprecated. And these are the only badges that mod menu is covering by itself. However, mod menu badges lets you have your own custom badge. Now remember, if you look at mod menu badges lib, the way he is telling you to depend and add dependency to your mod, especially this Gradle section, is wrong. It won't work. But the thing that you need is this mod menu badge generator. It's a little website that lets you type your text, choose the background color, choose the foreground color, border color, and then it will give you a little bit of a code snippet like this that you can add to your files and see that badge with the text, with the colors, and everything. And that's it. I can type tech and I will choose some purplish color for the background and border. And that's it. And I can just copy this code, paste it in the proper place. We will talk about it. And whenever I run the game, I will see this tech being shown exactly like this badge beside my mod's name. Okay, let's start adding the dependencies. The first thing we need to do is to add a single maven to our build.gradle, and that is the modrinth maven. At the end, you will add this maven URL equals to https://api.modrinth.com/maven. That's the maven repository for modrinth. Now, the dependencies are actually easy. I will copy them and paste them. And of course, you can go and check the GitHub repository, or you can pause the video and retype it. Basically, we say mod implementation for com.terraformersmc.modmenu and mod menu version. Take note, from early days of our development, we already had Terraformer Maven, so we don't need to add that one. However, for mod menu badges, we go with modrin. So we have this mod implementation, but before that, we put include parentheses and then the dependency inside the parentheses. This will cause a special behavior. Each time you build your mod, the library will be added to your mod jar file so that a user doesn't need to go on and download and install mod menu badges as a separate mod in their pack. Basically, it is included in your mod, and your mod will be a standalone in this aspect. This include means that. And if you note, we already have few here. For example, the custom portals have an include. The PAL has an include. The signs and libgui has include. An energy API has include. And if I use my fluid, it will have an include. So wherever you see this include means that they will be injected into your mod. Okay, so mod implementation, maven.modrint:mod-menu-badges-lib:, then the version from your Gradle properties. Okay, for Gradle properties, as always, I provide a little bit of information and the link on top. And then the versions, again, these are from Modrint. So you just look at the versions and it's really easy. If you go into any mod in Modrint, there is a versions section. When you see the correct game, for example, this is 1.20.5-1.20.6, you just click on it. And on the right side panel, here is the version number. You just copy whatever is below that, and that is this version. Same goes for badges version. Now, when you had done it and you saved both files, you need to go and resync your Gradle, and I will do it and come back when we are done. Okay, everything is ready now. If we run the game as it is, you will see something interesting. At the first screen of the game, now we have this mods button. Click on that. We go into this window. If we scroll down, we see our mod. This is the mod info. If I click on it, move my mouse on the name, we see the mod ID. We see the mod version, the author, the info. And if we produced any website or issues, we will take a look at that later. And the source and the license. We see everything here. And if you notice, we have this badge for mod menus that is client and the Minecraft itself called Minecraft. Okay, let's see where we can tweak these info and add more. You remember that under resources, you have this fabric mod JSON. Now, normally on contacts, you just have homepage and source. You can now add this issues entry, and this is the issues link from my GitHub, and this is why you had seen an issues button there. So basically, this is the website, this is the issues, and that source link inside the text came from here. Now, the mod ID is from being read from here. The version is fetched from here. The name, the description, the author, everything is coming from this fabric mod JSON. However, we can tweak and make things more interesting. At the end of these suggestions, or wherever everything is done, before this last curly brace, put a comma, hit enter. Now we want to start a new entry called custom, colon, curly brace, open and close, enter. Here we will define two different sections, one entry for mod menu, colon, curly braces, and then after the curly braces, another entry for MCB. Don't misspell it. It should be this. MCB. Colon. And here we are not using curly braces, but just braces. And basically, these are the two sections that we can add stuff. The top one is the mod menu itself, and the second one is the badges library. So for mod menu, we can add lots of things. You can read about them in GitHub, but normally, you would want to add the link for maybe a social media, normally Discord, and you should use this same key, modmenu.discord, and then give your Discord link. And if you use this update checker set to true, every time a player runs the game, the mod menu will check if you have a new version of your mod and inform the player. However, keep in mind, it only works with Modrint. So you should publish your mod on Modrint for this to work. Okay, there are other things here. For example, you can define badges here. Normally, as I said, there are only two badges that you can provide by mod menu itself. One is library and the second is deprecated. If you put a deprecated badge, it means that you will not update your mod anymore. And it's just there for back compatibility and you won't support it in future. The library is for library mods. And when you put the badge as library on your mod, normally it won't show in the list of the mods because mod menu by default has a setting that turns off the library mods from the list. You can turn it on and then you will see your mod with the library badge and everything will work. However, we added a library so that we can have our own badges. Remember this? Custom, MCP, brace, curly brace. This thing inside the curly brace is one entry for one badge. So I used the same website and created two badges. This is one, comma, this is the second badge. So one is storage, the second one is tech. The label color, fill color, outline color all came from the website itself. So I just, you know, I put a text here and played the colors and got the result. Nothing fancy there. Okay, let's run the game and see the result. Until Minecraft builds and the client came up, you may not have this suggests section. This is what mod menu badge library told to put it here. And as you see, it suggests the library to everyone, and that's harmless. So I added it at the end. Normally you have this depends and that's the end of the file. So if you want, you can add the suggests and then this custom beneath it, and that's it. So waiting for the game to come up. Okay, let's go to mods. And if I scroll down, now you see my two badges beside my name, storage and tech. Notice that when you select some mods, some of the mods have configs. We will come back and add our own configs to our mod. But if a mod has a config, here is when you can find them. So if we go here, you see that libraries are counted and list is compact or standard. And then here shows libraries are hidden. You can check it and it will say that libraries are shown. And then if you put a libraries badge on your mod, then mod will be shown in the list. You can hide the badges if you want. And, you know, you can use customizations like localization, and the GitHub repository of mod menu has enough information about that. Now that we turned on the libraries, you see that architecture, cloud config, and cloud base math side by side with Fabric API, Fabric Loader, Jenkson for JSON, Java, LibGui, and few others, Mixins Extras, Terra Blender, Terraformer API, and these are libraries. And now they are shown in the list. So you can have them, you can hide them, it's up to you. We have our own badges, and notice beforehand we had these links and source alone. Now we have Discord, so we can click and copy to clipboard or visit the Discord. And when I say we, I mean players can find you on Discord easier now. If you like these videos, please subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and turn on that bell so that when I publish a new video, you will get informed. Have fun, everyone. Bye.